Hunting the Menu is proudly brought to you by the Sporting Shooters Association of Australia. Join us at SSAA.org.au.
Okay, hold it, stop. Gotcha. G'day and welcome to Hunting the Menu. We've got a fantastic show lined up for you today. Here's a little taste. A little bit of an Italian surprise.
Now we're just going to flare our fish and get it cooking.
Hey boys, how we going?
I thought there was a spring in the air.
Very excited, our first show.
Yes we are, Corey.
Hope you got
yes,
something special for
me? You read it out.
What have you got there? Curry crusted trout wraps and venison Wellington. Oh, two of my favourites there, mate.
Yep, a little touch of the Orient and some of that old classic.
Beautiful, beautiful. Yeah. Shane, you got a spot for both of these, mate?
Sure do, mate. A few hours west of here, we should be able to find both of them, hopefully.
Yeah.
Hopefully the creek hasn't dried up too much and there's some trout left, otherwise it might be curry crusted carp wrap.
Oh, I'd prefer trout, mate, if we can.
Yeah, that'd go well, that'd go down well in Eastern Europe, the carp wrap.
Hey, carp's alright, we'll have to do carp.
We'll try that in another show, huh?
For sure.
Then we get the venison there as well?
Might get red deer or hello.
Okay. Alright, let's get packed up and get out of here, huh?
Rightio.
Beautiful.
A little over an hour and a half inland from home, we turned onto a property Shane had access to. We could have fished the stream further down where it was closer to the main road. But let's face it, if a farmer or property owner is going to give you a way to reach parts of the river most can't, then your chances of hooking up increase tenfold. A little bit of easy four-wheel driving and we were at a section of the river that few had fished. I'd like to tell you the name of this place, but as a true fisherman, Shane had that vaulted.
Oh, Shane, what a great spot.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Certainly is. You know, grew up on the coast, but every time Dad said to me, hey, let's go fishing, packed the car and off we went trout fishing.
It's great fun, mate. There's something special about these little creeks and that, and poking your way along the edges. Yeah, it's really nice.
These little hidden places like this, you know, they generally will deliver fish.
They can do, mate, that's exactly right. Some areas there's some good fish in them, some areas there's still a fair few carp that we sort of need to do something about. But
what are you going to use today, Shane?
Mate, I've got some little soft plastics there, some little Selta type spinners, okay. Some little rainbow trout imitation minnows there, so.
No fly today?
No, not fly rod in this country. She's a bit steep and rugged.
Okay, no worries. Well, I'm going to stick to my trusty spinner. It's always worked for me.
Okay.
Let's get down there and see what we can get.
It's going to be unreal.
This was a great little stream with plenty of pockets of water that looked like they should hold fish. And right when I hooked the bank, Shane was onto a nice rainbow.
So I've had probably five or six casts in this pool, and up towards the head of the pool there, there's a bit of run and some more of this grass hanging over the edge there, and here we go. First fish, and he's a keeper too.
You got one, Shane?
Yeah, mate.
I got that excited, I dropped my bag, my rod.
Gonna come and lift him out for
me? Let me see the first one. Yes, mate. Come on, buddy. Oh, he's a nice little keeper. There we go. Beautiful.
Unreal.
Look at that. Isn't he a nice fish?
Excellent. A couple more of them will be right.
Two more for me, mate, please. I'm a little hungry today.
All right.
That's a nice little rainbow.
We needed just one more for the pan, or I was going to go hungry. I was hoping Shane's luck was continuing, as mine hadn't changed.
Damn blackberries. For that seemed for 100 years, it'll be too soon.
There you go, mate.
Mate, the only thing getting caught down there was me. These blackberries, I copped it in the hand. I looked down, there was blood on the ground. I thought, where's that coming from? Pouring out of my hand.
There's a few of them, isn't there?
Yeah.
So, no good.
No good. How'd you go?
I got a couple, mate, back on the esky.
Oh, well, we're going to have to share.
Yeah, we can.
All right, let's
go. No worries. We better head back and get them cooked up,
I'm looking forward to what you're going to cook me.
A nice lunch, I think.
Yeah, beautiful. Time to go anyway. That wind's up.
Out here, every step counts. Out here, every moment is measured in success or failure. Oftentimes, it is the little things that keep us coming back. But many times, it is what we do not see that determines it. Let us help you see the unseen. Swarovski Optic.
Morning, we caught a couple of trout. We're going to cook them up outside, but unfortunately it's blowing a gale, so we've kicked the sheep out of the shearing shed behind us, and you can probably hear them in the background. And we're going to just do a quick take on a flowered fish. It's just a simple, straight dish that we do. Most of the things I've got here that we're going to use today are things that you take with you, so it's not very difficult to make. It's just a quick, simple dish. First thing that we're going to do is we're just going to cut a lemon and a lime in half, squeeze it over the trout, let it sit for 10 minutes or so while we get the oil and the seasonings side of things sorted out. Don't worry about seeds, squeeze it on. Now we're just going to do the lime, same thing, just cut it in half. Like I said, don't worry about the seeds, squeeze it on, give it a good squeeze, get plenty of juice out of the lime. There we go, just like that. Just get a fork, just move it around a little bit, let those juices soak into the meat. Next we're going to do our seasoning mix. So we've just got plain flour, some cracked pepper, some salt, and a good teaspoon of curry powder. So we're just gonna mix that around, blend it all together, like so. That's ready to go. We're gonna get our oil into our pan now. A little bit more than what you'd use if you're shallow frying, but not quite to completely submerge the fish. Okay, while we're waiting for that to heat up, we're just gonna quickly peel a couple of carrots and get them sorted out. A bit of capsicum now. Just knock the side of a piece of capsicum, don't use too much. Thinly slice that. Over there. The tomato, which is very easy, simple thing to do. And then just a bit of cucumber. Just like that. Righto. Now we're going to check the temperature of our oil. Easiest way to do that is just with a bit of water, just on your finger, flick it in. Starting to crackle now, but not exploding all over the place, so the temperature's about right. We'll just turn it down a little bit. Trout's very, very easy to overcook, so you don't want to cook it too much. And as you can see, the trout is actually starting to change colour now, and that's because of the lemon and lime juice. So we just need a couple of eggs. And there like so. Just a quick whisk with your fork. It's very similar to just flouring fish as normal, but what we're going to do is just do it in flour, the seasoned flour, the egg, and then back into flour. And what that'll do is it'll actually help protect the fish a bit more from overcooking. Now we're just going to flour our fish and get it cooking. Just going to move these out of the road for a second. Grab a plate. So flour, egg, flour is all we're going to do. So your piece of fish, turning white now because of that acid in the juices, flour into the egg, and then back into the flour. And that's it, ready to go. And just repeat that process until you've got them all nicely covered. What the curry powder is going to do is it's just going to give it a nice little bit of extra flavour too, but hopefully it should bring a bit of colour out as well. Now, like most freshwater fish, trout are no different to yellow belly and cod. A lot of people say they can have a muddy flavour, and all of that can be just from the fish not being killed and cooled quickly. It's one of the most important things with freshwater fish is to get them into an ice slurry as quickly as possible and cool the body temperature down. That's because that's where you get most of your muddy flavour from. As the fish is still warm and it's pumping pheromones through the lateral line in the backbone, and that's where you get your taste from. So if you cool them down nice and quickly, they're usually quite good. This is working a treat, this. Look at the colour of this fish. Here we go. You can see the yellow coming through on the fish already from the curry powder. Hopefully that should come up nice. Just turn the oil back up now. Got to remember that once you've started putting things in, oil cools down quite quickly. All right, so they're cooking. We just quickly get our wraps ready now. So a bit of nice little bit of lettuce mix. Another one. Stuff going everywhere. I'm trying to go a bit quick here so we don't overcook the fish. We'll turn all the fish now because it looks like it's colouring up quite well. A bit of salad. Capsicum. A little bit of tomato over the top. Whatever tickles your fancy, really. A little bit of cucumber. Putting the cucumber on there now because it goes really well with the curry. A little bit of curry flavour that comes with the fish. Plus we've got some Greek-style yoghurt here that we're going to pop on top. Fish is good. Just a couple of nice little pieces of fish. Hope these wraps are big enough. Hey, Cole, how you going?
I just thought I'd pop in and see if you needed a hand with this.
We're just about all done, mate.
Are they those fish I caught?
That seems to happen a lot.
Yeah, I know, I know. Mate, they smell delicious.
They look too bad, don't
you? I mean, I love trout straight out of the river, but this has got to be better.
Let's see if I can get them wrapped up. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get them wrapped up, Cole.
Is that mine, mate?
That's yours.
Beautiful. How about I get another plate for you here, and you can put yours on there. Shane, they look delicious.
Thank you.
Beautiful, mate. Nice job. This all could right. be my new favourite trout lunch, I think.
Yeah, could be. It comes to show you.
Yep. We'll have them do their work, and we'll get out of here.
The thing that I really have enjoyed is the people. We're like a big family.
In a day's training, I might go through anywhere between 300 and 500, maybe possibly 600 rounds.
I see that firearms are an essential tool for the farmer.
The first shot I ever did, it felt amazing. I felt glad that I actually did something that I felt passionate about.
How good is this? Open fire, you can't beat it.
No, it's pretty nice, isn't it? Good night too.
Yeah, well, we're all unpacked, ready to go for tomorrow. What's
yes.
our plan?
No, I think we'll go and have a look for a deer first thing in the morning, mate.
Shane, what type of deer do we hope to see out there?
Mate, there's a lot of fallow through this country, quite a few, but there is quite a few red deer sprinkled in amongst them as well, so fingers crossed we can come across one or the other, that's for sure.
Shane, there's a lot of growth around. Is that going to make the deer a little bit more scattered?
Look, at the moment, the way the country looks, you know, as we're coming in tonight, I think it's they're not going to be very easy to pattern, but that's what makes it a little bit difficult, is that they don't have to come out of the scrub as much to feed because there's a lot more feed in the scrub as well. So it is quite a clear night, so it might be a bit chilly tonight, and hopefully they might bed up in some of the blackberry choke gullies and that to keep warm and amongst the granite rocks and stuff. So,
Shane, the forecast I saw for tomorrow is below zero, so hopefully your blackberry theory will be spot on.
Let's hope so, mate. We'll rug up nice and early in the morning and head out and see what we can find as the sun comes up.
Fantastic. Hopefully tomorrow we're taking home a esky full of venison.
That'd be nice, wouldn't it?
It certainly would.
Fingers crossed.
Next morning, the cold had arrived as predicted. After a quick heart starter, we grabbed the gear, wiped off the frost, and headed out. Seen something there, mate?
Yeah, it looks like we've got a couple of red deer down here, mate, at the bottom of the gully.
Oh, yeah. How far off you reckon they are?
I don't know. I'll let you know, eh? Bit over 800.
What's our plan?
Well, they're probably not going to go too far now that the sun's just coming up, and they've probably been sleeping in this deep blackberry gully down here overnight, so I'd say they're just probably going to feed up into this timber line here, and we'll try and scoot back around the back here and come down this other hill and see if we can get in front of them, and hopefully they'll feed out and we'll get a decent shot at one.
How spooky you reckon they're going to be?
Oh, I don't think they're going to be that spooky, mate. We've come in on the buggy and they don't seem that concerned about it, so, and the cows are making a hell of a lot of noise over there earlier, so they should be right, mate, I reckon. We'll leave the buggy here and we'll just go and have a go.
Shane, this game trail's nice and worn.
Geez, mate, it's had a bit of use, hasn't it? Good thing to walk along too when we're going through this sort of timber to keep away from all the branches and sticks and leaves and stuff. It just makes walking a bit quieter down here, and hopefully we don't disturb these two down here. Starting to feed out. You see him, mate? There's one just feeding out now.
Okay, I can see him coming out behind the trees.
A few kangaroos there too.
The other one's a bit covered at the moment.
Yeah, the other one's just behind a bit, in the shade still.
Now, which one are we going to go after here?
Well, the front one's a hind. Take the back one, mate. Looks like a young spiker. It should be nice.
Okay.
Just wait for him to settle a bit and come out from that shadow. And
I'm just going to chamber around.
Yeah, nice and quiet. That's it.
You coming across the field there?
Yeah, wait for him to come down. See that? Yeah, wait for him to pull up in front of that black bush that's on the ground there. They should stop, hopefully, before they get to the creek. Righto, mate. There you go. Take him.
Okay. He's dropped straight away, mate.
Beautiful shot, mate. Well done.
That's what I like. Very clean.
Nice shot. Good on you, mate. Beautiful. Like a lot of venison.
My kids love the venison.
Awesome.
They love the venison schnitzel.
Well done.
I'll be very happy.
Oh, good job, mate.
All right.
Well done.
Thank you, mate. Okay. Time to go and grab him and
Now the hard part.
Yeah.
Very good.
I don't think any of it's real easy, but getting him out of there is going to be quite a task.
So the boys have been out way the other side of the Great Divide,
and they brought me back this absolutely beautiful piece of venison. It's a backstrap. It's big enough to feed an army, but we're only going to use about this much. Now, they're expecting the dish that we've discussed, a venison Wellington. But before that, I'm knocking up a little bit of an Italian surprise. It's called carpaccio, and this is how you do it. Carpaccio is very thinly sliced beef in its traditional sense, but we're doing it with venison, and it's cutting quite beautifully. You can see how tender the meat is. Unbelievable. It's going to be a very different twist on a very old recipe. Now, that should be enough to start with. So let's move across here so that we can cover them with clear film and give them a little tap with my trusty rubber mallet. Now, I'm just going to tap them out here. As you can see, the meat is so tender, it's tapping out very, very thin indeed. That's what we're after. Very thin. You can almost see through it. Okay, so once we've draped the plate like this, we're going to dress them up. Now, for dressing them up, I've already got mandarins in the olive oil, which is the main dressing point. But in addition to that, we're going to squeeze a bit of lime juice across the lot. Lime and venison go very, very well together. In fact, lime can replace lemon in just about everything and taste better all the way through. A little bit of oil, going to drizzle it around. Pepper and salt, always season. Don't use pepper out of that's already been done. Make sure you grind it fresh for a dish like this. And just for looks, let's just roll the mandarin segment in the meat until we've got the entire plate full. I'm going to give it a final twist of pepper on the outsides because this is basically the underside of those little pieces of carpaccio. And the pièce de résistance, or the final bit, we're going to add some capers. They add a real zing to this dish, an absolute zing. So the carpaccio is in the fridge, chilling out, waiting for the boys to come back. And I'm going to get on with the hero dish, the venison Wellington. First of all, we've got to give this a good dousing of oil. We want it to be really, really well oiled. That's salt going on, a little bit of pepper. A squeeze of this lime juice on the top, just to thin it out a bit. Now, with that, I'm going to take this and put this on a char grill over here and just sear it off and seal it on both sides. This is the barbecuing part for all you blokes out there. There's the venison. It's now just going to be there for less than 2 minutes, I would say. You only want it a couple of minutes each side. The idea is not to cook it, but just to warm it through and to sear it. Now, the searing adds a bit of flavor to the already delicious piece of meat. So now it's time to do the rub. And the rub is not a dry rub, it's a wet rub, butter-based with a bit of oil. Now here, I've got fresh herbs. I've got thyme, I've got a little bit of rosemary, I've got parsley, and I've got bay leaves. They're all going into there for the first bit of crunching. So I'm gonna just open those up to release some of their juices. Now, time for the cumin powder and the coriander seeds. Nice and dry, nice and crunchy. Boy, I can tell you now, the smells are amazing. They're coming out of here, the blend of the fresh, young, sappy green, and the dried cumin and the coriander seeds is quite overwhelming. Now we're gonna add in the butter. Now the butter also adds a nice richness to this. Grind a pepper and a pinch of salt. There we go. Now let's get this up into a paste. Now this is the end game, really. This is preparing the Wellington for the oven. And what we need here is the paste or the rub smoothly smeared across the meat. This is all about covering the meat and giving it a smooth layer between it and the pastry. So let's put this piece down now on here so we don't lose any of that marvelous rub. In case you've been wondering just what the bacon's for, well, it's an additional piece of moisture. Now I'm going to roll this over here to control that. There we are. Now we want to crimp the ends, and they can just be crimped up just like you're doing a pasty. Now on the top, we've got an egg wash. You can just brush that all over, and job's done. In the oven at about 180 for 30 minutes.
Too late to call?
It's always too late to call.
Yeah, I know
you're
late. Do I
say sorry, really late? I bought a peace offering.
I knew you would. Oh.
Red wine for you, beer for me. Thank you. Yeah,
very good indeed. So you guys were magic this time. You've always brought me good stuff, but this is...
What do you found?
What did you prepare earlier?
As you can see.
Look at that. What's this?
That venison was so sweet, I had to do something special. This is an Australian twist on an old Italian standard called carpaccio.
Dos, I got to try one of these.
Yep. You've eaten sushi all your life.
Yeah, not raw meat though. No, sushi plenty of times.
It's a run. You'll get over it when you have that first flavour. What do you reckon?
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
There's no gamey flavour or anything in it.
It's funny, isn't it? Because it should have, but it hasn't.
Well, when you're aging it, you can smell the meat, you know, and it's got that bit of gamey, but in that, there's nothing. That's beautiful.
Gentlemen, better late than never.
Thanks, Doss.
Beautiful, Doss.
Venison Wellington.
Beautiful. Here, mate.
Thank you, sir.
There you go. You're not joining us, mate?
I've been eating carpaccio all day.
Good on you.
And I tell you, cheers, it's mate. Filling.
It looks beautiful. Let's dig in.
Thank you, sir.
Is there enough for the crew?
Oh, I think so.
Boys, come and jump in.
Do you mind if I slice up a bit?
Yeah, get them a little bit there.
Thank you very
fantastic.
Much.
Fantastic. Yeah.
Don't you want up?
Yeah, I want up, but just give it a break before I talk and you talk, because I've got nowhere to go then. So look at the camera.
Where are you talking?
No, when I'm talking to you now, because he's recording.
You're talking to me?
Shut up, just do it. Okay, recording.
Okay.
No, that's straight after me, you see?
No, I haven't started yet. Okay is just to give you your cut break. Oh.
Hunting the Menu is proudly brought to you by the Sporting Shooters Association of Australia. Join us at sssaa.org.au.